Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech. And after using iOS 14 Beta 5 for the past couple of days, quite a few people have messaged me and found additional features or changes that have been added to Beta 5 as opposed to what I mentioned in my What's New video, where I went over all the major changes. So I wanted to go over all the new changes and give you a shout out if you help me find that feature. Now, I've found some, you've found some, and so let's go over those in a moment. Now, I'm running it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and I've also got iOS 14 Beta 5 on the iPhone 7 here. Now, for comparison, I also have iOS 14 Beta 4 running on the iPhone XR, so I can show you the differences. Now, the first thing I get asked every day, so I just wanted to make this clear and answer it for you, is quite a few people are asking me, does Call of Duty work? And Call of Duty Mobile does appear to work. It does occasionally crash, but it does seem to actually work. So if you wanted to try that out, it should be working if you were afraid to update. Now, let's go over the new features. And the first thing is Safari. Safari added a little updated feature. So if you go to, say, apple.com, for example, and then you tap these two A's, we get a privacy report. Well, previously we had to go into the privacy report to see if there were any trackers contacted. So if we go to beta 4 to compare, you'll see here, privacy report doesn't say anything underneath it. You actually have to go into it to see the actual privacy report. Whereas before, you didn't get the little summary. So it's nice just to have a quick summary instead of actually having to open it to see which sites are tracking you. So it's nice that they've added that. Now, they've also fixed something. So if you're using, say, the shortcuts widget, if we go to edit and then we add a widget here, we'll go down to, say, shortcuts. Maybe we'll add this one. We'll add this size. And then let's put this on our secondary screen here. Before, this was sort of a blank widget. And so if you wanted to add something, you could, but it was blank until you added a new shortcut. So if you edit the widget, we can edit the shortcut, and then maybe we want to turn Bluetooth on with it. Now, when we go back to the home screen with the shortcut, it says Bluetooth on. So they've updated that and fixed it, and it's working like you would expect now if you want to put an individual shortcut on a separate page of your apps. Now, Jawad Ali helped me find a different feature I didn't know was there, and that's under settings. So if you go to settings and then you go down to privacy, and then you go to location services, scroll all the way to the bottom, go to system services. Under system services, there's a new device management framework. This was not here before on the previous beta. So this is something that I'm not exactly sure what it's for per se, but it looks like they've added it. So we'll go to location services, go down to the bottom, go to system services, and you'll see it's nowhere to be found. So device management framework is new. What specifically it allows you to do or allows developers to do, I'm not exactly clear, but if you know, please let me know. And thanks to Jawad for sending that along. Now, the next thing has to do with spatial audio. Now, spatial audio was not added to this particular beta, but they did add a little menu or animation per se that gives you an idea of what it will look like. Mac Rumors actually found this, or at least mentioned it. And as you can see here, here's what it looks like. It's within the code. So it's not yet turned on if you have AirPods Pro, but they did add that slight little change. So hopefully they'll turn it on sooner rather than later. Now, a couple different people sent me the next one, but Matthew Dunn sent it over first. So that has to do with the photo widget. So if we go to the photo widget here, you can see it selected a featured photo. And if we don't like this photo, we can tell it not to show it again. However, there is a bug. If it's actually featuring something that was a memory, it doesn't work properly. However, if it's showing a featured photo that we have here, which it often uses, you can press and hold on that featured photo and say, remove from featured photos, and it won't show on the widget anymore. Now you can delete it from your library, and this goes for anything that's showing up under featured photo. So if you have a few different ones here, they'll show up, and then you can just remove them under the For You tab. And so that's a slight change. Also, a slight change has to do with the naming down here. So you'll see it says library, For You, and albums. And if we go to the photo album on the previous version, it's a little bit different. So let me find my photos here. So under my photos, you'll see that instead of saying photos, it now says library. I don't know that it makes much of a difference, but on the far left there, the icon says library instead of photos. So not a huge change, but it is something to note. Now, something that's great for older cameras is you can change the resolution now by tapping on the icon when you're in a video mode. So in the upper left, you haven't been able to do this on older phones, but on this iPhone 7, if you want to change between video modes, you can do that, but you first have to turn on a setting. So if you go to settings and then you go down to your camera, there we go. We'll go to camera. You'll see under here, we go to record video and you have the different formats. And now you have video format control. Simply turn that on. We'll go back to our camera here. And under camera, it says 4K 30. If we tap on it, now it says HD 30. Go back to 4K 30. So now we can finally just tap and select. It should have been there all along, but now you can use it on older devices as well. So it should be supported on hopefully all of them. I've tried it on the 7. If you have an older phone, an iPhone 6S, for example, or even an SE, let me know if it's working for you. Now, also on older phones, some people were saying that when you were charging the phone, the percentage would disappear. I actually noticed this. So it showed the percentage here. And then as soon as I plugged it in, it disappeared. I had to re-enable that setting again for it actually to work. So I had to go into settings and then under battery, I could re-enable it. So we'll go to battery here. Turn on battery percentage and it fixed it. So for some reason that was broken before. Now it's working properly. And I'll talk more about other issues in my follow-up video in a day or so. Now, also speaking of battery, if we go into our battery settings, go over to battery, they've changed this a little bit and we'll wait for it to load. And down here, you can see that it now says last charged to 86%. So this was in my car. It charged up to 86% and it's letting me know that's what it was last charged to. So you won't get an accurate reading with that until you actually charge to 100% and let it drain down. And that will give you a better idea. You've also got the icon again, telling you when you plugged it in and charged and then when it was discharging. So it's updated a little bit. Hopefully they change this even more in the future to be a little bit more comprehensive. Now, someone on Twitter named iBob actually found a feature. Now, I'm not sure if this feature is specific to beta 5, but this is sort of obscure, so it's hard to know for sure. But what it does is when you remove your SIM card and switch to, say, a new SIM card, it gives you a message now. And so let me slide over. I screen captured these and downloaded them, but you'll see it says, your iMessage or FaceTime number will continue to be registered for iMessage FaceTime. You can disable this number in message settings. And then if you go over to settings, you can remove it from FaceTime and iMessage. So it says this SIM is not currently in your phone. However, since this is a two-factor authentication number, you can keep using it for iMessage and FaceTime for a limited period of time. And so it's a nice new feature. I'm not sure if it was there before since it's sort of obscure. So if you've seen it before, let me know, but it's great that they've added that to remove your number from two-factor authentication. So it doesn't get used by anything else. Now, another change has to do with using sleep or bedtime. And so you can see on your home screen, once it's enabled, we've got a little bed there on the right with beta 5, where before it just said sleep well. So it's changed for some people, although I didn't see this until I actually enabled bedtime using the control center. So I actually had to use control center to enable it here. And then it worked properly for me. So I didn't see that change. There may be a few bugs with it, but I had to enable it that way in order to see it properly. Now, if we take a look at the buttons at the bottom now, let's change it so that we go into jiggle mode here. And now you can see they've changed the icon with the pages at the bottom. They've made the icon a little bit larger now, and the area or spacing around the dots has changed also. So it's just a little bit different. Maybe they've moved it up slightly as well. Now, along with the design changes I've already mentioned, there's quite a few other ones as well. So the folders are a little bit longer. So if we go to beta 4, maybe open up a folder, you'll see that the folder's slightly longer and the design has changed a little bit. I'm not sure if that's better or worse. As long as it's symmetrical is more what I care about. So I think they'll probably fix this again in the future. Now, another thing they've changed is if we go to settings and then we go to home screen on both of them, they've changed the text at the top. It says newly downloaded apps as opposed to new app downloads. It's a slight change, but they do change wording all throughout from time to time. Now, when dark mode is enabled and you take a look at the notes widget on the new version, beta 5, is darker. It's more of a pure black, where it was a little bit more gray on beta 4. This is the reverse of what we saw with the calendar in this beta as well. So they've updated that. It's just a slight change. Now, also, when you add a widget, so we'll just press and hold, they've actually organized them a little bit differently. You'll see the way they look is slightly changed for the battery. So they've just updated some of the overall look of it to better fit, I guess, what they want as far as the style of it. I imagine this will change closer to the final release as well. Within the Shortcuts app, they've updated the glyphs as well. So we'll go in and maybe go into this shortcut. And if we want to change the glyph or the icon here, we'll go to glyph. They've added a bunch of new ones under objects, people, and symbols. So there's additional ones if you want to better customize this, whether that be for a tool, scissors, battery, for example. We can change it to battery. You have a bunch of different choices for icons. They keep adding more and more of these as the betas go on. So maybe we'll see even more by the final release. Now within music, they've made some changes as well. If we go into music and then we'll select the same mix, we'll hit play. There we go. And you'll see the background is slightly different on beta 5. If we go to the next song, let's get out of the same album here. There we go. You'll see the background updates a little bit differently. It may be a little bit quicker, but it's also different colors to better match the album. So we'll go through these and you'll see that it's a little bit different as it goes through the different albums. So it's a little bit brighter, maybe a little bit more vibrant, and it's a slight change. Now within radio, they've also changed from Beats 1 to Apple Music 1. And so you can see this already. They've made this change on all versions, but for whatever reason, they got rid of the word Beats. Some people have said that Beats is going away permanently, but it's really hard to say. And so those are the major additional changes throughout. A lot of small visual changes, just like they did here in the control center with Home. But there's also some little tweaks and changes throughout where they move icons ever so slightly. Now, I don't generally cover those. Just like in Home, there's some slight changes, and I don't always cover those under automation and things because those can change throughout. But I like to see them continually progress through these different visual changes throughout the OS, and I think we'll see a few more by the time it's finally released to the public. Now, let me know if you found anything else. And thanks again to everyone who sent all of those different changes and updates in. I really appreciate it. And look for a follow-up within a day or so after I do the poll on the YouTube community page. So thanks again. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll leave it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.